Hi guys, David and David here from PayItForward.com and Upphone.com, and in this video we're going to talk about iOS 13 settings you need to turn off now.
Mm-hmm. Apple has a way of making sure that the settings they want you to have on get turned back on during the software update process, so we figured we'd make this video because iOS 13 came out recently. And it's a good idea to check this no matter when it is. So the first tip we have is actually really cool, and I was excited when I found it. It is actually the ability to turn off those annoying pop-ups that ask for reviews within apps. I didn't know that existed. Let's head to the Settings app and then head down to iTunes and App Store and then scroll down to In-App Ratings and Reviews.
It's especially annoying too when you just download an app for the first time and right away, first time you open it, they're asking for a 5-star review and it's like, I haven't used the app yet.
Yeah.
So just tap that switch, turn it off. There you go. Problem solved.
That's awesome. I couldn't believe when I saw that that's an option for us now.
Mm-hmm.
So our next tip is to turn off iPhone, iCloud, health, analytics.
Yeah, especially if you have all these switches turned on too. You're sending some health data if you have it set up in the health app on your iPhone, mm-hmm. which is a little weird to me.
Yeah. There have been some privacy concerns recently where Apple was caught in the news. They were listening to people's Siri conversations.
Yeah.
Anyway, they're not always the most transparent about how they use your data. Tap back to settings. Scroll up to privacy, and then scroll all the way down to analytics. And pretty much we're gonna turn off everything in this list.
Yeah, if you just tap share iPhone to watch analytics, that automatically turns off most of these switches.
Mm-hmm.
And then just tap share iCloud analytics. Turn that switch off, problem solved again. Mm-hmm. Next, we're gonna turn off any unnecessary location services.
Mm-hmm. And let's tap back to privacy and head up to location services. Location services is the GPS of your iPhone, and we don't recommend turning it off entirely. Instead, take a look through the list of your apps here. And pay attention to any apps that say always, which means that app would always have access to your location.
Yeah, and I have one. It's my CEFQ app. It's my credit union.
Okay.
So we don't want them to have access to my location always. They don't really need it, do they?
I don't think they need it at all.
Yeah. So I'll just tap never top of the screen.
Yeah, and if you're having battery problems or your iPhone's getting hot, sometimes it could be just one app that's not set up correctly. If the developers don't know what they're doing and they say the wrong settings, then this could solve big problems on your iPhone. Let's tap back in the upper left-hand corner. And after you go through this list, just, you know, turn off the ones you don't need, scroll down to the bottom and tap System Services, which is our next tip. We're gonna turn off everything in this list that we can. And so the only ones that we recommend leaving on are emergency calls and SOS, find my iPhone, and share my location if you use it. So let's go through that.
Start turning off these switches. Keep those two off.
Right. Compass is still gonna work. You're still gonna connect to cell networks. You're still going to be able to do Wi-Fi calling and Wi-Fi networking. And let's go into significant locations too. This is the creepy part.
Yeah.
And David actually just recently cleared that out.
Yeah, I had like 5 locations and it was a little weird.
Yeah, just tracks you everywhere you go to be able to deliver appropriate content to you.
Yeah, but if you see your locations first, just tap clear history. I don't have any history here, but if I tap it, it's gonna happen.
And let's
turn it off. Just turn off that switch at the top of the screen, turn off. Apple doesn't need to know your significant locations.
Yep, all the time.
It used to be called frequent locations, which is weird, and then they kind of massaged it with significant
locations because people were freaking out about frequent locations. Yep. So let's tap back and then scroll down to the very bottom of this menu where we find more analytics that are hidden. So like just turn off all of these, the iPhone analytics, popular Airbnb.
These are strictly for product improvement too. We think Apple is smart enough to make their own products better.
Our next tip is background app refresh. Background app refresh allows certain apps on your iPhone to download new content in the background when you're not using the apps. So you can imagine that not every app needs to be updating itself all the time. You can use your cellular data. Let's tap back the upper left-hand corner.
Back to privacy, back to settings. Tap on general, tap on background app refresh. First thing to keep an eye on here, tap on background app refresh at the top of the screen and just select Wi-Fi instead of Wi-Fi and cellular data. You don't want to be using cellular data to background app refresh your apps.
Right.
That was said poorly.
That's good enough though. Yeah, because you don't want background app refresh to always be running.
Yep.
Step back in the upper left-hand corner and then just go through this list and turn off the switches next to the apps that don't need to be downloading new content all the time.
Yep. Apple Store, no. Burger King, no. Books, no.
Right. Maybe you want ESPN to stay on because you always want to be able to open the app and have all the latest scores right there.
Yeah. Voice memos, no. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But a lot of them you could just turn off. It's going to save battery life and cellular data. Our next tip is switching your mail from push to fetch. With push, your iPhone maintains a connection to your email server all the time. It's constantly checking to see if there's new mail, uses data, and it uses a lot of battery life. With fetch, you decide how often you want your iPhone to check for new mail. So let's tap back in the upper left-hand corner and back to settings and tap
passwords and accounts.
Yep. Mm-hmm. And then tap fetch new data at the bottom where it says push and turn off push at the top.
There we go. And then just under fetch, how often do you want your mail to fetch? Mm-hmm. We say 15 minutes is pretty good. And you can always just check your mail by opening the mail app. You don't have to wait the 15 minute intervals every single time.
Yep. And iCloud is a service that's built by Apple. So I recommend just leaving that on for push. I've never really had a problem with that, but I have seen problems with other mail providers like Microsoft Exchange and Outlook, where it's not as optimized for the iPhone and it destroys iPhone batteries.
Yep. Yep. So the next thing to do is disable microphone camera access for apps that don't really need it. Mm-hmm. Again, you don't want these apps to be able to look through your photos.
Mm-hmm.
Privacy issue there. So go back to accounts, back to settings, and tap on privacy. Now here, let's tap the Photos app, for example. These are apps that might have access to your photo library. Mm-hmm. They could access your photos and do
yep.
what they want.
Could send them to a different server. This is the result of clicking the yes pop-up mm-hmm. when you open an app and it says this app wants access to your photos, this app wants access to your camera. And you can go back and change those settings after the fact. Mm-hmm. So we recommend doing that. Make sure there isn't anything weird in these lists where an app has access to your camera or your photos that you don't want it to have access to.
Like for Instagram, for example, you're uploading photos, it needs to have access to your photo library if you
Makes
want to
sense.
Do that.
Yep.
Makes sense. So go ahead and do the same thing for microphone, speech recognition. Just make sure there are no weird apps that have access to those things in your iPhone.
Yeah, that's interesting. Microphone, speech recognition? The wrong app could be sending your voice to God knows where. Next up, we're gonna talk about third-party keyboards. With iOS 13, Apple released the swipe keyboard, so you can swipe now, but you used to have to download third-party apps to be able to do that. So back in the day, I downloaded Gboard, which was Google's keyboard, mm-hmm. because I wanted to be able to try the swiping thing, and then I decided I didn't want to use it.
Right.
But third-party keyboards can have access to everything you type on your iPhone, so they present kind of a security risk. Let's head to settings in the upper left-hand corner and scroll up to general. And then scroll down to keyboard, and then keyboards at the top, tap on that. David has the English US keyboard and emoji, both of which are fine because they come from Apple, and then Gboard.
Yep.
And multiple languages.
Well, let's just tap on Gboard. Mm-hmm. So it has full access mm-hmm. right now.
Just toggle that switch on and off, off and on. And it says full access allows the developer of this keyboard to transmit everything you type, credit card numbers, street addresses. That's why it's important to make sure that the keyboards that you're using are developed by people you trust. So tap, let's just say don't allow.
All right.
And then let's go back to keyboards and remove Gboard. Tap edit in the upper right-hand corner, and then just tap that minus circle and tap delete.
Yep. Google's pretty reputable, so is Bitmoji. Those are probably fine, but mm-hmm. other keyboards we'd be a little bit wary of.
Yep. And if they're not necessary, sometimes you find yourself clicking through that little globe icon on the keyboard and you're cycling through all these keyboards that you don't need. This is a way to make your iPhone just a little bit easier to use too.
So those are iOS 13 settings to turn off immediately. Thank you guys for watching. Give it a thumbs up if you've enjoyed. Leave us a comment down below. Do we miss any settings that we should be turning off on our iPhones? And don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more great iPhone videos.